It's time now for the latest in local news. In the news, 34-year-old Courtney Southers remains in jail awaiting a court hearing as she faces 15 felony counts in connection with the house fire in Scriven, Georgia. On Monday, the GBI released a statement in which their investigation reveals that Southers compelled her 12-year-old stepchild to start the fire. 34-year-old Southers has been charged with arson, insurance fraud, aggravated assault, and cruelty to children. Statement from the GBI reads as follows, quote, based on footage and interviews, investigators determined that Southers talked to her 12-year-old stepchild to start the fire inside the home for insurance money. The suspect was arrested on July 18th and remains in jail, end quote. The fire occurred at 199 Pine Circle in Scriven, Georgia. The home was a complete loss. Southers facing 15 felony counts, including first-degree arson, insurance fraud, 5 counts of cruelty to children, 7 counts of aggravated assault. Once again, at this time, no court appearance has been scheduled. We need to follow the story as it develops, but again, the GBI releasing the fact that she compelled her 12-year-old stepchild to start the blaze. John Jankowski remains in jail since his arrest back on June 22nd, but he'll be back in court with his attorney, hoping once again for a bond. That's taking place tomorrow morning in Wayne County Superior Court before Judge Bert Guy. At his first hearing, Judge Roger Lane denied bond, but a second bond hearing has been scheduled for the morning. Jankowski faces charges of distribution of controlled substance, criminal attempt to commit rape, and sexual battery. At the first bond hearing, Assistant DA Tiffany Montenegro told Judge Lane that they have 12 sworn affidavits, one woman who say John Jankowski drugged them. He's charged with drugging an undercover agent who had to be hospitalized, and they find opium in her system. At the last hearing, Assistant DA stated to Judge Lane that they found the same substance, opium, in Jankowski's truck the night of his arrest. Jankowski, represented by attorney Adrian Browning. Once again, they will seek a bond from Judge Bert Guy in the morning. WIFO FM will be in court. Have a full report for you on Thursday's newscast. We'll be back with more news after this word from our sponsor, other commercial messages, so please stay tuned. Other news, longtime Georgia Transportation Commissioner Tom Moreland passed away on Monday. The Georgia DOT confirmed his death and said his impact on Georgia's transportation system is immeasurable. Moreland spent more than 30 years at Georgia DOT, rising to chief engineer before serving as commissioner from 1975 to 1987. Oversaw some of the state's largest transportation projects, including the current version of Atlanta's Downtown Connector. Also oversaw the reconstruction of the I-85 interchange at I-285 northeast of Atlanta, which now bears his name. But the Tom Moreland interchange is better known in Atlanta's Spaghetti Junction. After retiring from Georgia DOT, he founded Moreland Altabelli Associates, their civil engineer firm, which Wayne County City Jesup has used many times on projects here in Wayne County. His firm grew to more than 300 employees before it acquired another firm in 2017 known as Atlas. Once again, longtime Commissioner of Georgia DOT Tom Moreland passing away Monday. School year quickly approaching. Again, we've got High School Principal Brett McDaniel on the Mitch and Bob Show this coming Thursday to talk about some important information about the upcoming year at Wayne County High School. School begins Friday, August 4th here in Wayne County. All open houses for Wayne County schools has been set for Thursday, August 3rd from 3:30 to 6 p.m. All parents and students are invited to take advantage of this opportunity to visit the school, meet the teachers, get your schedules. High school is conducting a freshman orientation that Thursday, August 3rd from 12:30 to 3 p.m. in the high school auditorium. And this is for students only. For freshmen, at 2:30, they'll ask the parents to join their students for a brief informational session before the open house begins. Once again, open house for all students in schools in Wayne County, set for Thursday, August 3rd from 3:30 to 6 p.m. Arthur Williams conducting their annual Jumpstart for all incoming sixth graders. That's set for August 1st from 5:30 to 8 p.m. at Arthur Williams Middle School. The school nursing system advising parents that there are immunization requirements that must be met before children can attend school in August. Students entering seventh grade next year and all children who are new entrants into a Georgia school in grades 8 through 12 must have received one dose of the TBAT vaccine, one dose of the meningitis vaccine to meet immunization requirements. In addition, all Georgia students 16 years of age or older who are entering or transferring into 11th grade will need proof of a meningitis booster. Immunization requirements for children of all ages can be found on the Wayne County School System's website. And the Wayne County Board of Tourism getting ready for their annual or their first Touch a Truck event, inaugural back to school event, taking place in downtown Jesup on Saturday, August 5th from 9 to 2. The event, again entitled Touch a Truck, will feature heavy equipment, emergency vehicles, tow trucks, bucket trucks, along with food and information booths where kids can see the trucks up close. The event will be centered around West Walnut Street between North Macon and Northeast Broad Streets. Streets will be closed to vehicles. The first hour of the event will be a quiet hour for sensory-sensitive children. During this time, no sirens will be used. Businesses are encouraged to shop local businesses in the downtown area for back-to-school supplies. For a vendor or booth information about the Touch a Truck event, contact Heather Altman at the Wayne County Board of Tourism Office at 912-427-3233. Or for vehicle participation, contact Donnie Ray at 912-424-0376. Again, Touch a Truck set for Saturday, August 5th from 9 to 2 in downtown Jesup. We'll be back with some final news notes after this word from our sponsor, the commercial messages, so please stay tuned. Final notes news, Hospice Society Georgia selling tickets to their fundraising event entitled Market to Midnight, coming up on Saturday, August 26th from 7:30 to midnight with the band Six Piece Suits performing. The event takes place at the Wayne County Farmers Market at 533 North 1st Street in Jesup. Tickets are on sale now for $15 each. They're available at Hospice Society Georgia, and the night will include dancing, some silent auction items, and food vendors. All proceeds benefiting Hospice Society Georgia. Need more information or a ticket, contact Kylie McGregor at 912-588-0080. This is an election year in Wayne County. Cities of Jesup, Bowdoin, and Scriven all set for city elections in November. Qualifying for those city elections will begin on Monday, August 21st. Election date is November the 7th. In Odom, the election will be for the position of mayor in the five council seats. In Scriven, the elections for council seats 1, 3, and 5. And in Jesup, the election for this mayor position and commission seats 1, 4, and 5. Qualifying period will run for a week up until August 25th. In Jesup, the qualifying fee for all positions is $3. In Odom, the qualifying fee for a mayor is $10.50. The council seats $7.50. In Scriven, the qualifying fees for all candidates $36. Last day to register to vote in the city elections is Monday, October the 10th. In Jesup, several candidates have announced they're seeking office, including former Jesup Police Chief Perry Morgan. He's announced he's a candidate in District 1. Incumbent Shirley Armstrong not expected to seek re-election. District 4, incumbent Stanley Todd's announced he's not seeking re-election. In District 5, which remains vacant since the passing of Ray House, former city manager Mike Deal has indicated he'll be a candidate in that seat. And it appears more and more likely that the seat will remain vacant until the election in November. City Council simply couldn't reach a decision on who should fill the position. They're hoping that the Governor Brian Kemp would make that appointment, but it appears that Governor has more important things to do than to worry about a District 5 commissioner seat in Jesup. That's going to do it for latest in local news. Sports is coming your way in a few minutes. Bob Morgan, same a great day.